Hi everyone, welcome to the class. Today we are going to prove the following statements which were given in our worksheets. So many students are asking the proof of these statements. That's why I'm explaining this. For any positive integer n, prove that n cubed minus n is divisible by 6. Or show that the product of any three consecutive positive integers is always divisible by 6. To prove these statements, both statements is same, but question is different. So how to prove these statements? For that we have to take three consecutive positive integers. And we'll prove these statements. So take three consecutive positive integers. For this above statement, n minus 1, n plus 1. If you want to prove this above statement, first statement, we have to take the consecutive statements as n minus 1, n plus 1. For the below statement, we can take this n minus 1, n plus 1, or n comma n plus 1 comma n plus 2. Three consecutive positive integers. Consecutive means what? The number which follow in order, they come up without gap, that numbers are called consecutive numbers. For example, 7, 8, 9 are consecutive numbers. The product of these numbers is 7 into 8 into 9. It is divisible by 6. Let us verify this one. 2, 3 is 6, 2, 4 is 8, 3, 1 is 3, 3 is 9. So 7 into 4 into 8, we get the product. So it is divisible by 6. Let us take another example. 10, 11, 12. These three are consecutive positive integers. If you multiply them, it is called product. It is divisible by 6. 2, 3 is a 2, 5 is a 3, 1 is a 3, 4 is a. Like this, this product is divisible by 6. This is the numerical proof. But we have to prove theoretically. So to prove these statements, I'll put the first statement by taking three positive integers. Let the three positive integers as n minus 1, n, and n plus 1. So if we take 8 as n, this becomes n minus 7 is n minus 1, and 9 is n plus 1. Like this, n minus 1, n plus 1. Then product of these three digits, three numbers, what will be the product? N minus 1 into n plus 1. Here n into n, n square, minus 1 into n, minus n. Now multiply n square minus n with n plus 1. N square into n, n cube, plus n square into 1, n square, minus n into n, minus n square, minus into plus minus n into 1 n. Here these two numbers, plus n square minus n square, will get cancelled. Then the remaining numbers are n cube minus n. This is the product of three consecutive positive integers when we take those numbers like n minus 1, n plus 1, 6, See here also that is given n cube minus n. Here also n cube minus n in the question also. So to prove this statement, we have to prove that the using by the statement by using test of divisibility. If a number is divisible by three and two, then the number is divisible by six. By six. The product here, the product is n minus one and n plus one. If the, this product is divisible by three and also by two, we can conclude that this product is divisible by six. Any number is divisible by three and it is divisible by two, then it is also divisible by six. For example, if you take 18, 18 is three divides 18, 3 6 jai 18. 18 by 3 is equal to 6. 18 by 2 is equal to 9. Then 18 also divisible by 6. 6 1 ja, 6 3 ja. So the same way we have to prove that n minus 1 and n plus 1 is divisible by 3. We have to prove that one. And also we have to prove n minus 1 and n into n plus 1 is divisible by 2. If you prove these two cases, then it automatically it will prove that it is divisible by 6. Let us take first case and prove that one. Case 1. If within the this one, first case we have to prove product is divisible by 3. To prove this, if any number, any positive number divisible by 3, it leaves 0 or 1 or 2 as remainders. Any number it gives remainders 0 or 1 or 2. So the number may be in the form of, then any positive integer is in the form of three q or three q plus one or three q plus two. Here q means quotient. That means any number, if it is divisible by three, it leaves here no remainder. Here one remainder, here two remainder. This is written according to the division algorithm. Divisor into quotient plus remainder is zero here. Here divisor into quotient plus remainder one, divisor into quotient plus remainder two. So any number can be written in the form of 3q plus zero or 3q, 3q plus one, 3q plus two. Now let us verify by substituting these values in n minus 1, n and n plus 1. If we take n minus 1, let's take n minus 1, because we have selected three numbers those are n minus 1 and n and n plus 1. Now we got the number forms as 2q, 2q, 3q, 3q plus 1 and 3q plus 2. To substitute these three numbers in the place of n and check whether which number is divisible by 3. So I will take three numbers in serial and I will verify here. Okay. Now I will write here 3q. Plus 1 and 3q plus 2. Here n minus 1, n and n plus 1. If I take 3q, 3q plus 1 and 3q plus 2. If I take 3q in the place of n minus 1, 3q and here also 3q. And 3q right in the place of 3q. Then subtract here, 1 is here. Subtract 1 from the number 3q minus 1. The right number n is equal to 3q as it is, nothing to be added here. And here n plus 1 is there. I have to add 1 plus 1. I will take n is equal to 3q like here. So I substitute in the place of n and I verify. Here 3q minus 1 is not divisible by 3. Not divisible by 3 because this is 1 less than the multiple of 3. So here, therefore, that is not divisible by 3. So here 3 is the multiple of 3q is a multiple of 3. So it is divisible by 3. And here, 1 more than the multiple of 3. 3q is divisible by 3, but 1 is not divisible by 3. So 3q plus 1 is not divisible by 3. So among these three numbers, 3q minus 1 not divisible, 3q is divisible, 3q plus 1 is not divisible. Only one number is divisible. If you take 3q plus 1 in the place of n, we'll take 3q plus 1 here. 3q plus 1, 3q plus 1, 3q plus 1, and we have to subtract 1 from this first number, that means n minus 1. This is n, and n minus 1, n plus 1. This is n plus 1. N means 3q plus 1, and subtract by subtracting this, we get plus 1 minus 1 cancel, we get 3q here. And here 3q plus 1 and here 3q plus 2. Among these three numbers, which number is divisible by 3? Here 3q only divisible by 3, 3, 1, 3. But here 3q plus 1 not divisible by 3 because here 1 is remainder. So here 3q plus 2 also not divisible by 3 because here also 2 remainder. So here among these three numbers, n minus 1 is divisible by 3. Among these three numbers, n is divisible by 3. Let us take third number and write them and check, verify that one. 3q plus 2 is equal to n. N is equal to 3q plus 2. Here also n is equal to 3q plus 2. 3q plus 2, let us substitute in the place of n. In n minus 1 and n plus 1. Here minus 1, we have to keep minus, subtract minus 1. Here n, write as it is, here add 1. By Simplifying this, we get 3q 2 minus 1 plus 1. Here the same number, 3q plus 2. Here we get 3q plus 3. Among these three numbers, this is not divisible by 3 because here remainder is 3, remainder is 1. Here remainder is 2, not divisible by 3. Here remainder is 3, divisible by 3. And this is also divisible by 3. So among these three numbers, last number, that means n plus 1 is divisible by 3. Among these three numbers, first one, that is n minus 1, n minus 1 is divisible by 3. Among these three numbers, the middle number is divisible by 3, that is n is divisible by 3. So from this, we can conclude that one of the three positive integers are divisible by 3. If we take any three numbers which are consecutive positive integers, only one of them are divisible by 3. Here we have seen, here this one only divisible by 3, here this one only divisible by 3, these two are not divisible by 3. So here also this one and these two are not divisible. So then their product also divisible by 3. Your product means n minus 1 into n plus 1. This one is divisible by 3. How? Any one of these three numbers is divisible by 3. That's why it is divisible by 3. We can take some numbers. 7, 8, 9, 3 consecutive numbers. In these three conjugate numbers, 9 is divisible by 3. Therefore, 7 into 8 into 9 also divisible by 3. 3 1 ja, 3 3 ja. So we can say n minus 1 into n plus 1 is divisible by 3. Now let us take second case 2. In this case, we have to prove that these consecutive three numbers are divisible by 2. We have to prove n minus 1 into n plus 1 is divisible by 2. Let us start the proof. If any positive integer is divisible by 2, is divided by 2, it is divided by 2, it leaves remainder zero or one. We know that it leaves zero or one. If it leaves zero remainder zero, it is called even number. If it leaves one as remainder, it is called odd number. Then any positive number can be written as one of the form of form of 2q plus 0 or 2q plus 1. That 2q plus 0 means the multiple of 2 plus 0, that means even number. 2q plus 1 means odd number. This is equal to 2q and 2q plus 1. Now let's substitute these forms, form of the numbers in the consecutive these three numbers, n minus 1, n and n plus 1. Let us substitute these numbers. Okay, here we take three consecutive numbers, n minus 1, n, n plus 1. Here we take the form 2q and 2q plus 1. You substitute 2q in the place of n. And 2q in the place of n, 2q, 2q, 2q. Here subtract 1 from the number. 2q minus 1. Here write 2q as it is. Here 2q plus 1. Among these three numbers, which number is divisible by 2? Only this 2q is divisible by 2. This is not divisible by 2 because 1 less than the remainder 2q minus 1, multiple of 2, and 1 less than the multiple of 2. 1 less than multiple of 2, not divisible by 2. Here 1 more than the multiple of 2, 2 into here quotient plus 1, 1 more than the multiple of 2. So 1 is not divisible by 2. Therefore, it is not divisible by 2, it is odd number. So only n is divisible by 2. Here only n is divisible by 2. Now let us take 2q plus 1. Substitute 2q plus 1 in the place of n. 2q plus 1 in the place of n. Now here we have to subtract minus 1. Here nothing to be subtracted, nothing to be added, nothing to be subtracted. Keep n as it is. Here add 1. Here we get 2q plus 1 minus 1 cancel. We get 2q, and here 2q plus 1, and here 2q plus 2. Among these numbers, what are divisible by 2? Among these numbers, 2q is divisible by 2 and 2q plus 1 not divisible by 2. 2q plus 2 is divisible by 2. Two numbers are divisible by 2 here. So 2q, because 2 2 ja 2 1 ja 2 is divisible. We can verify this truth. This is also is divisible by 2. So if you take even numbers, n is equal to odd number. Here is n is equal to even number. This one, this is n is equal to odd number. For example, here even number means 4. Here before number 3, after number 5. N minus 1, n, n plus 1. So 4 is divisible by 2. So it is true, middle one. If you take odd numbers, 5 before number 4, after number 6, predecessor, successor. So here 4 is divisible by 2, 6 also divisible by 2. Only middle one is not divisible by 2. So that's why middle number is not divisible by 2. So at least one of the number in minus 1 and n plus 1 is divisible by 2. Sometimes one number, sometimes two numbers also divisible by 2. So we can conclude that at least one of the n minus 1, n, n plus 1 positive integers is divisible by 2. This is second case. From 1 and 2, from first case, from 1 and 2 and second case, we can conclude that n minus 1, comma n, comma n plus 1, their product is n minus 1 into n plus 1, is divisible by both 3 and 2. Therefore, n minus 1 into n plus 1 is divisible by 3 into 6, 3 into 2, that is equal to 6. This is the proof of this problem. So here n minus 1, n plus 1, positive integers divisible by 2, then product, its product also divisible by 2. Product n minus 1 into n plus 1 also divisible by 2. So if we take an example for this, we can prove that n minus 1, n plus n, n plus 2, 3, 4 are three numbers, conjugate numbers. In these two numbers are divisible by 2. So their product also divisible by 2, like this 2, 1 jar, 2 cancel. 3 into 4 is the result, is a quotient. So in this way, it is also, we can conclude that the product is n minus 1, n plus 1 divisible by 2. From 1 and 2, we can conclude that n minus 1 into n plus 1 is divisible by both 3 and 2. That's why it is divisible by 3 into 2, that is equal to 6. So this is the proof of the given statement. By using this, we can prove the other three remaining problems which are given in the workbook. Those are, number one, prove that one of every three consecutive positive numbers, integers, is divisible by 3. Similarly, prove that this is case 1 in the above proof, case 1. Prove that one of every three consecutive positive integers is divisible by 2. This is case 2. Previous one is case 1. If you study the case 1, this is case 2. You can write the answers for these two questions. Moreover, one more question is there. Show that one and only one of n plus 2, n plus 4 is divisible by 3. Where n is any positive integer. So we have to take divisible by 3 means we have to take the same manner 3p, 3p plus 1, 3p plus 2 and substitute in the place of n. First take 3p and substitute the place of n. N in the place of n plus 2, n in the place of n plus 2, n in the place of n plus 4. If you substitute 3p, then first case n is divisible by 3. If you take 3p plus 1, then the substitute in the place of n and n of the n plus 2 and n plus 4, n plus 1 plus 2, n plus 3. Second case, second number is divisible by 3. If we take n is equal to 3p plus 2, then it is not in the substitute in this place of n, it is not divisible by 3. In the place of 3 n plus 2, 3p plus 4, not divisible by 3. If you substitute here 3p plus 2 plus 4, 3p plus 6, it is divisible by 3. The same manner, the same method, follow the same method and solve this third question. Okay.